The birth of a baby can start a variety of powerful emotions, from excitement and joy to fear and anxiety, but it can also result in something you might not expect: depression. Most new moms experience postpartum baby blues after childbirth, which commonly include mood swings, crying spells, anxiety, and difficulty sleeping. Baby blues usually begin within the first 2 to 3 days after delivery and may last for up to 2 weeks. But some new moms experience a more severe, long-lasting form of depression known as postpartum depression. Sometimes it is also called peripartum depression because it can start during pregnancy and continue after childbirth. In this video, we will discuss how common is postpartum depression and what are some risk factors associated with it. We will also explore its causes, signs and symptoms, diagnosis and treatment options. First, let's talk about how common is postpartum depression. Well, it is estimated that approximately 1 in 7 women may experience postpartum depression. It affects around 10 to 15% of new mothers globally and most commonly occurs within 6 weeks after childbirth. Postpartum depression is more common in adolescent females and in mothers who deliver premature infants. Now, there are several risk factors associated with postpartum depression, including psychological factors, obstetric factors, social factors, and lifestyle factors. Psychological factors may include a history of depression and anxiety, premenstrual syndrome, negative feelings towards the baby or the baby's gender, and a history of sexual abuse. Obstetric factors may include complicated pregnancies such as emergency C-sections and hospitalizations, meconium passage, umbilical cord prolapse, preterm or low birth weight infants, and low hemoglobin levels. Some social factors that can contribute to postpartum depression includes lack of social support and domestic violence. Lifestyle factors such as eating habits, sleep cycle, physical activities, and exercise may affect postpartum depression. Now let's understand what actually happens in the body and brain during postpartum depression. The underlying mechanism of postpartum depression is multifactorial and includes genetic, hormonal, and neurobiological components. One of the primary hormonal factors contributing to postpartum depression is the sudden drop in estrogen and progesterone levels after childbirth. This hormonal shift can lead to changes in neurotransmitter levels, particularly serotonin and dopamine, which play crucial roles in mood regulation. The decline in these hormones can disrupt the normal functioning of the brain, leading to symptoms of depression. Genetics also play a significant role in the development of postpartum depression. Research has identified several genes and polymorphisms associated with PPD. These genetic factors can influence an individual's susceptibility to postpartum depression and the severity of symptoms. Certain neurobiological factors such as disruption in reproductive or lactogenic hormones, stress and HPA dysfunction, and neuroinflammation are also seen in postpartum depression. Now that we have explored the mechanism of postpartum depression, let's move on to its signs and symptoms. The signs and symptoms of postpartum depression include depressed mood or severe mood swings, difficulty bonding with your baby, withdrawing from family and friends, changes in appetite and sleep disturbances, fatigue or loss of energy, less interest and pleasure in activities that you used to enjoy, intense irritability and anger, feelings of worthlessness, shame, guilt, or inadequacy, difficulty concentrating or making decisions, severe anxiety and panic attacks. Thoughts of harming yourself or your baby, and recurring thoughts of death or suicide. Let's now discuss how postpartum depression is diagnosed. Diagnosing postpartum depression involves a combination of medical history, physical examination, and behavioral assessments. Besides this, certain standardized screening tools such as the Edinburgh Postnatal Depression Scale, which is referred to as EPDS, can be used to diagnose postpartum depression. The EPDS is a 10-item questionnaire related to feelings and behaviors. A score of 12 or higher indicates a high risk of postpartum depression. Based on medical history, physical examination, behavioral assessments, and screening tools, a doctor evaluates symptoms and determines whether the patient is experiencing postpartum depression. Since postpartum depression is a complex condition, it requires a comprehensive treatment approach. The most effective treatment for postpartum depression involves a combination of psychotherapy and medication. Psychotherapy or counseling is often recommended as a first-line treatment for postpartum depression. Therapeutic approaches such as cognitive behavioral therapy, referred to as CBT, interpersonal therapy, referred to as IPT, and supportive therapy can help individuals address negative thought patterns, improving coping skills, and enhance emotional well-being. In cases where symptoms are severe or do not improve with psychotherapy alone, medications may be recommended. Antidepressant medications such as selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors or serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors are commonly prescribed to alleviate depressive symptoms. Besides antidepressants, a drug known as zuranolone can be prescribed. Zuranolone is the first oral medication approved by FDA for treating postpartum depression. Brexanolone is another medication approved for postpartum depression. Now, healthcare providers need to weigh the risks and benefits of medication usage during pregnancy and breastfeeding and collaborate closely with patients to ensure safe and effective treatment. So this was all about postpartum depression. We hope you have found this video helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to comment below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more informative content.